Then to run the load flow analysis, I will go to the mode toolbar and I will click on the load flow analysis mode. And on the right side, I have this option, run load flow. I will click on this option over here. So I will have to put in an output file name, F1, load41, and I'll click on OK. So this gives some values over here. So this is 100%, 99.88%, this is 99.16, and same for here. This is the power flowing from the power grid to your system. We do not have the units as of now, so in order to make it more understandable, I will go to this over here to unit show, which will show me the units. So here we have the units with us. So this is like 4.5 megawatts of power flowing from the grid over here, and we have about 1.5 megawatt coming from the 2 megawatt generator. This thing is in red color, so I think we have a warning over here. We look into it. We have an alert view option over here, which alerts us about any type of overloading or excitation. I will show you some other features on this load flow analysis mode. So let us see. Right below the run load flow, we have the auto run on. So I'll click on the auto run. So anytime I go from this load flow mode to any other mode, this data will be gone. So I'll come back over here. So this will automatically run the load flow analysis and give me the values over here. So I'll keep this off as of now. Okay, we'll go into the alert view. So in the alert view, we have two windows over here, a critical window and a marginal window. So for the critical window, we have the generator one, which is a generator, and the condition is overexcited. Okay, we'll come back to it later. And next we have this report manager over here. From the report manager, we can generate reports that we need for our system. So if I click on this load flow report, and we can save it to any format over here. So I'll just keep it in the viewer and click on OK. And here we have the report over here. So I'll just maximize for you to see. And okay, so we have these buses over here, and this is our swing bus over here, and this voltages are provided, and here the voltages are provided in percentage. I think you're familiar with the per unit system, so you should understand this 100% and 99%. So here we have generation at the bus 1 is about 4.5 megawatts. And similarly at bus 3 we have generation of 1.5 megawatts, and the loads connected at bus 3 are also shown. So this shows the flow of power between, the flow of power through every line, amps flowing through every line, the power factors at every nodes. And I will just close this over here. And here we have the load flow result analyzer. I will click on this. So the study reports, we have the study case, which I put it over here. And let me see, diversity factor is normal, type number of buses, branches, generators, power grid loads, etc. And we can select this over here. And this is nominal, and we have the voltage over here, MW loading, percentage loading, and we can also change these Over here we can change the marginal and the critical conditions, under voltage and over voltage conditions. And that's it. I will click on close over here. Next we have the display options. We can select this display options over here. Here we have this as default selection. So this is kilowatt plus JKVAR. So I will just change this to amps. And I will click on OK. So we have about 23 amps flowing from the power grid. Here it becomes 24, which goes through the transformer and becomes what is here. And over here, this is what I showed you before, and I can change this from the amps to anything else like kW or kVAR or anything from this option over here. The default selection is that all the voltages are shown in percentages or per unit systems. So if I want to know the actual voltage, we can come over here, select this and change this to kV. So this is 110 kV, and here we have what, 109.9 kV, and here this will be for a 10k, for 11 kV bus we have 10.9 kV. We can also change this to volts. I like to use the percentage, which makes more sense to me. If you want, you can change. And here we have the load terminal voltages. So here we have 99.16 percentage at the terminal, and here too we have 99.16. And if I open the network over here, here too we have 99.16. So let me go back. Turn this off and to the line and cable voltage drop. So here the voltage drop after coming through my transmission line is 0.1 percentage from here. So that makes sense somehow. That is, here 100 percentage voltage becomes 99 percentage of voltage. So that makes sense. And here we have, this is 0%, and here too this is 0%, because there is no significant drop in voltage. I think I selected those cables which are very wide, very large cables, so there's negligible voltage drop across them. So I'll just turn this off. Results panel and UPS systems. We don't have any UPS systems in this. Nothing to show there. And next I will go to the load analyzer option over here, and let me click on this. So this is the load analyzer option, and we can change the load diversity factor and power factor and efficiency. We can change pretty much anything for any different loading category. So default this is put on design, and if we want to go to the winter load, and I will change this to like bus max, bus min and so on. Just I will not be changing any of those values. I'll just go and click OK. Okay, then I'll just close this one. And over here, then we have this presentation bar over here, and if we go and click on this briefcase over here, this is a study case, and this is the new study case. If we want to make a new study case, that is, we have to click on this. We can duplicate the same study case to the other, and if you want to edit the study case, you can come over here. So the load flow study case is over here, and we can change the units over here, operate percentage, operating unit voltage, power in MVA or anything else. So we can also change the method for load flow analysis. So at present it is kept at adaptive Newton-Raphson method. So we have a precision about 0.0001, which is very good. So I'm not going to change anything. And initial voltage, bus initial voltages, etc. And can change this alert view over here. We can change this generator power grid excitation and etc. over here, and so on. And the emergency, we could change the generator emergency handling, the CB status, and everything else over here. And that's okay, that's it for this option over here. And if you go to this new presentation over here, we could just copy our single line diagram to a new edit mode, which I won't do as of now. So you can change this over here and so on. If you want, if I'm going to the configuration manager, we can select the different elements over here. So when I clicked on all AC loads, we have all the loads coming over here. We can change this to intermittent, spare, or anything else. So let's close this. And here we have the cable manager. The cable manager shows all cables that are used for our single line diagram. So 15 kV cables and a single, okay, the conductor per phase one, conductor per cable one. So this is single core cables and these are copper cables, okay. And these are the insulations. I'll just click on close. And this is how you run a load flow analysis on Etap. And I see you in the next lesson.